Town officials in the Philippine province of Zamboanga del Norte denounced the massive destruction of a mountaintop forest in their area. This report tells us a firm that was newly granted an exploration permit is already conducting mining operations there.
This is Mount Mona Lisa in the municipality of Gutalac in the southern province of Zamboanga del Norte. It is blanketed with lush forests and surrounded by rich waters. But it is slowly changing following the approval of exploration activities for mineral resources. In videos obtained by ABS-CBN News, trees have been uprooted, upland areas have been flattened, and a nearby water source has also been affected. The exploration activities are being undertaken by the Florhenmar Mining and Development Corporation, or FMDC, and its contractor Zamboanga Nickel Corporation after securing a permit from the Mines and Geosciences Bureau in Zamboanga Peninsula Region. Based on FMDC's application proposal, it wants to check for minerals in the area. The National Commission on Indigenous Peoples in the Zamboanga Peninsula has approved exploration in the area after the company and indigenous peoples there supposedly reached a mutual understanding. However, an inspection by the local government showed the contractor is doing more than just exploration.
Ang amin lang is i-provide lang yung mga requirements. Na ngayon hindi wala silang papel tapos binubuldos na nila lang area. Nakagawa na sila ng causeway, Philippine Ports Authority. Wala pa silang inisyo or na-approve na mag-conduct na sila or mag-construct na sila ng yung port.
Kulang po yung mga dokumento.
Walang dokumento, as in, wala.
Gutalac Mayor Eddie Kimbo insists work being done in the area poses a danger to indigenous people while also adversely affecting their livelihood.
Sa baba, nandun yung mga residente, population ng barangay Bakong. Pag may malakas na ulan, ilang araw na ulan o bagyo, ikawawa yung nasa baba. Si Bako na mag-landslide, ubos sila lahat. Masakit sa loob ko kasi yung mga tao ko, mga tao natin, wala nang mahuli na mga pangkabuhayan nila. Kaya naman octopus, isda.
Village officials have passed several resolutions opposing activities in the area, an ancestral land being claimed by the Subanen indigenous group. Residents also submitted a manifesto to Malacanang calling for an end to what they call as mining activities. MGB Zamboanga Peninsula Regional Director Hernani Abdon confirms FMDC has an exploration permit. Abdon also says he's aware of the illegal mining claims but investigations are still ongoing. The offices of the Department of Environment and Natural Resources in Gutalac and Zamboanga Peninsula have yet to respond to requests for an interview. However, a document from the DENR obtained by ABS-CBN News shows FMDC and its contractor is conducting site development which involves bunkhouses and other facilities. The DENR has suggested to MGB to issue a cease and desist order against the site development. Officials from the DENR central office have declined to answer media questions. ABS-CBN News also tried to get FMDC and Zamboanga Nickels to comment, but they are not responding to calls and texts.
Officials in the Philippine province of Oriental Mindoro are asking for more help to contain an oil spill caused by a sunken oil tanker. Fisher folk also worried about their livelihood after the Philippine Coast Guard banned fishing activities near the affected waters. Details from Dennis Datu.
Aerial footage at Dauhan, Oriental Mindoro, where the tanker MQ Princess Empress capsized early Tuesday morning. The vessel is carrying 800,000 liters of industrial fuel. According to the Philippine Coast Guard, diesel leaking from the ship's engine has caused 6-kilometer-long oil leak. They have yet to install an oil spill boom in the area because they are still looking for the submerged ship. The Coast Guard's Marine Environmental Protection Unit has sprayed chemicals and deployed machines that can absorb the oil.
Hindi naman siya ganun ka-itim, parang naghalo-halo na siya na fuel.
Meanwhile, local officials are worried the oil spill might damage marine protected areas, especially the Verde Island Passage, known as the world's center of marine biodiversity.
Ang bayan ng Nauhan ay may tatlo kaming marine protected area na nandun sa coastal area din, nasa Barangay Herrera, Masaging, at saka doon sa...
Yung na magiging epekto nito sa mga isda natin. We're doing now yung
pagbubuo ng team na una, mayroong makakapagawa, yung mga experts coming from the side of DNR and the consultants coming from the private sector, kasi pinupush na rin na even yung mga experts from the private sector ay makatulong natin.
Representatives from DNR EMB have gathered water samples from parts of Nauhan and from the marine protected areas to check if oil have reached these areas. Fisher folk are also worried about their livelihood after the PCG banned fishing activities near the affected waters. A crisis management committee has also been formed. The owner of the submerged marine vessel vows to cooperate with authorities to minimize the effects of the oil spill to the affected communities. Dennis Dato, ABS-CBN News, Nauhan, Oriental, Mindoro.
Philippine rescuers successfully retrieved the remains of four plane crash victims from the slopes of Mayon Volcano in Albay Province. Camarique Town Mayor Carlos Baldo Jr. said the bodies were brought to a forest ranger station close to the crash site. The retrieval operation was successfully completed 11 days after the ill-fated Cessna plane crashed near Mayon Volcano's crater. The aircraft's two Filipino pilots and two Australian passengers died in the crash. A search is underway for a helicopter that went missing Wednesday morning in the Philippine province of Palawan. The helicopter had five persons aboard. It was ferrying a female patient to a hot point and was expected to arrive at 10:30 a.m. at the hospital. The agency has dispatched officers to assist in the search efforts, and the Philippine Coast Guard has also joined the operations by deploying the BRP Malabrigo, which will focus on the coastal waters off Brooks Point and Balabac in Palawan. This is the third aircraft that went missing in the country this year. Philippine transport regulators give GP operators and drivers more time to comply with a requirement in the government's GP modernization program. But at least one transport group is not appeased by the extension and about to push through with a strike next week. Lady Vicentio reports.
After a Senate resolution calling for the postponement of the government's plan to phase out traditional jeepneys, the Land Transportation Franchising and Regulatory Board announced another extension of the deadline for industry consolidation under the PUV Modernization Program. This is the fifth time the LTFRB has extended the deadline to give operators more time to join cooperatives and corporations. The deadline is now moved to December 31, 2023 from June 30. Transport regulators say they were not pressured into extending the deadline following a planned transport strike next week.
To be honest, there is no pressure for us for the strike because more than 90% of the transport groups have signified their support to the program of the LTFRB. However, in deference to the Senate resolution of Senator Grace Poe and to the request of the Secretary of the Department of Transportation, we will be extending the deadline to allow the transport sector more time to consolidate.
The extension also came after President Ferdinand Marcos Jr.'s statement that the PUV modernization program should be studied further.
The modernization program also was a first step towards electric vehicles. Kasi ang sinasabi ng mga nag-aaral, kung talagang para sa climate change yan, kahit na mag-electric vehicle ka, mag-charge ka, yung kuryente galing din sa coal-fired plant. Di ganun din. E walang nagbago. Linipat mo lang yung pollution ng konti. So that's an improvement, but doesn't help climate change. That's why kailangan pag-aralan natin ang timetable.
The president also appealed to transport groups to consider the welfare of commuters.
I'm hoping na dito sa mga initiatives na iniisip natin, makumbinsi naman natin ng mga transport groups na huwag na muna mag-strike dahil kawawa talaga ang tao at marami pang naghihirap at hindi masalo pang maghihirap pag hindi makapasok sa trabaho.
A review of the program's provisions will be done by the LTFRB before issuing another memorandum circular. Despite this, Transport Group Manibela is not budging and says its nationwide transport strike is still a go.
Sagot po ba ito dun sa panawagan ko o na-pressure lang sila doon sa Malacanang o sa Senado? Diba? In-extend mo nga, tapos gusto mo pa rin akong isama doon sa existing cooperative. Crap nila yung ano, yun lang eh, hindi naman ako nananawagan na pahaba.
Transport Secretary Jaime Bautista said traditional jeepneys will not be phased out immediately if there is not enough supply of modern jeepneys.
Pwede naman i-extend pa rin yan, no? Kasi nga sinasabi ko nga, hindi naman natin pwedeng i-stop yung operations ng mga lumang sasakyan kung kulang yung supply, no? Kawawa naman yung mga pasahero natin kung basta na lang magtitigil.
Bautista reiterated his call for a dialogue with Manibela to address their concerns and clear up any misconceptions about the program. Lady Vicentio, ABS-CBN News.
Another security screening officer at the Ninoy Aquino International Airport is facing theft charges after getting caught on video stealing from a passenger. This comes just days after five officers were suspended due to a similar incident. The officer was caught on CCTV pocketing a watch of a Chinese national at the NAIA Terminal 1 Wednesday morning. The Office for Transportation Security assures the public they are doing their best to resolve the cases and complaints against their members.
Siguro ilan-ilan lang itong mga ano, yung mga tiwaling member ng Office for Transportation Security. Alam ko marami sa atin matituno dahil sa ating serbisyo kahit na mababa ang sweldo. So magtulong-tulong po tayo para linisin natin yung ating hanay.